This is my current prototype and idea for the actual form part of this screen. On the left, we have a list of topics. At the bottom, we have two buttons, new topic and reply. New topic, you see, if you click on that, we'll go over to the screen on the right. This is where you can enter a subject and a body and then submit. If going back to the original screen on the left, if we hit the reply button, it will put the topic subject that we're replying to at the top, and you can reply and submit. My current thought, though, is that initially I'm just going to try to allow someone to enter any information, hit enter, and it will go into a list, and then we'll just display the list back. The important thing here is to be able to save it to the cloud, and then be able to retrieve that information for the cloud. That's going to be step one. We're now back in App Inventor, and it's time to add some new components so that users can actually view and add to the forum. So let's go back to the designer. We currently have our two arrangements. We're going to add two more arrangements. So let's go to layout. And I'm going to add two vertical arrangements. Let's first just make them the width of the parent so that they're as wide as the screen. I'm going to make these two invisible right now, so I'm going to uncheck the visible box just to give us some space so that we can view what we're working on currently. Okay, so the top arrangement here of these new two ones. This is going to be the actual forum where the messages are listed. I'm going to rename this forum arrangement. The bottom arrangement is where the user will enter any new message they want to add to the forum. So I'm going to rename this entry arrangement. So let's go back to the top one, the forum arrangement. We want to list all the messages that are currently in the forum, and then we want to have a way to say, add a new entry that will take us to the second arrangement. So let's go to the user interface. I'm going to add a list view component that's going to list all the messages currently in the forum, and I'm going to add a button. Okay, it'd be nice to probably center these, so I'm going to click on the arrangement and center it horizontally. For the list view, this is going to list the forum items, so I'm going to rename this item list view. I'm also going to change the background color to white. I find that easier to read, and then change the text color to black, so just reversing it. That's just a personal preference. And this button is going to be for entering new items, so I'm going to call this new entry button, and I'm going to change the text to say make new entry, and let's just change this to magenta, maybe make the font size a little bit bigger. Okay, so that will be it for the form arrangement. Entry arrangement, this is where they will actually type in the message that goes into the forum. So for this, we want a text box and another button. The same with this one, I'm going to center it horizontally. For the text box, let's rename this body text box. So it's going to be the body of the message, right? So, and we're going to make its width the fill parent, so it's the full width. I'm also going to check this multi-line box so that we can have multiple lines of input. We're not going to limit them to a single line. And we will make the height, let's say 50 pixels, so that would give us, at 14 font size, at least 3 lines of text showing. So that should be sufficient. Now for the button, we're going to rename that. So that's going to be called submit entry button. And let's change the text to say submit. And again, let's change the font size to 18. So it's the same size as the one above. And let's just change the background to green. And this is all about saving things to the cloud so that we can share information between users. So we want to go over here to the left, down here to the storage drawer, and we're going to drag in a CloudDB component. CloudDB is our cloud database. It's going to allow us to store information in the cloud, our forum items, and also retrieve them and disseminate them amongst the users of the app. I want to ensure that this is the only one showing when we start up. Rather than do it here in the designer, I'm going to go to the blocks and code it there.